In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Google Drive on desktop in 2023. And you know I'm including some of the best Google Drive features. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a frighteningly large amount of Google content. Today is your complete Google Drive tutorial. So let's go. Okay, I've made so many videos on Google Drive, but I find returning to the basics every now and then to be super helpful. So let's first start with, what is Google Drive? Google Drive is a free cloud storage solution where you can store, sync, and share files across devices. So if you've ever created or read a Google Doc, for example, you've already used Google Drive. I like to think of Google Drive as your storage garage, where you keep all of your slides, docs, sheets, and so on. So then how do you access Google Drive? There are actually multiple ways to access Google Drive. I usually access my Google Drive from my Gmail or GCal. It looks the same from either spot. So here we are in my Google Calendar, and if we click on Google Apps in the top right, it's that square made of dots beside your profile picture. All your Google apps will pop up here, and you can click on Google Drive right from here. Or you can simply open up your browser of choice, and in your browser bar, you can just type in drive.google.com and hit enter, and you'll be taken to Google Drive, or you'll be prompted to sign into your Google account if you aren't already. And just so you know, they have Drive for personal and business use. So for this video, we're gonna focus on your personal Google account. So now that we know how to access Google Drive, let's take a look at the main layout. So luckily for us, Google Drive's layout really hasn't changed too much over the last year. Now your drive may look a little bit different in this main section here, depending on whether or not you have created any files, but the basic layout should be the same. We've got the navigation menu on the left-hand side. Here we also have a storage indicator. So this is gonna tell you how much storage your plan has, how much you've used, as well as a little button to buy storage if you need. I've actually done a few videos before on how to clear up Google Drive storage, as well as what counts towards your Google Drive storage. So I have linked to those in the description below. But for now, back to our Google Drive layout. At the top, you'll have your search bar where you can easily search for files and folders. And we'll touch on some search functionalities a little bit later on. And the main section of Google Drive is this My Drive section. As you populate your drive with files and folders, you'll have those in this section here, along with suggested files up at the top. Now, these are typically files you've opened recently or often or around this time of year or day or so on. Now, if your drive layout still looks a little bit different than what I'm showing, you can adjust your layout using the option near the top right to switch to a list layout or a grid layout. Really, it's just personal preference. Now, higher up in the top right is where you're gonna find your settings gear, and to the right of that is, of course, your Google Apps access. So now that you're familiar with the layout, let's learn how to create a new file in Google Drive and how to create a new folder in Google Drive. As you might be able to guess, you can click on New in the top left of your Google Drive, and here you'll have the option to create a new folder, upload a file or folder, you can create a Google Doc, a sheet, slides, or forms, and then you'll have more options underneath that as well. Alternatively, you can also just right-click on any empty space in the main section of your Google Drive here to create new files and folders. So if you don't have anything in your drive yet, a good place to start would be to create a new folder. So really think of how you want to organize all of your files here. So as an example for this video, I've created a YouTube assets folder. So go ahead and create whatever folder it is you want. I will create a client outreach folder and then hit create, and bam, right here under folders, you should have your new folder. Now, if you're in list view, and I will toggle back to show you that here, you will be able to get a quick snapshot of the owner of the file, when it was last modified, and by who, as well as the file size, which is really handy. I'm going to toggle back to my grid view. So if you want to upload a file that already exists on your computer, we're going to head back to new and select file upload. Then just select the file you want to upload and it'll be added to your drive. Essentially, any type of file can be uploaded: video file, PDF, image file, Photoshop file, and so on. Plus, you can upload multiple files at once by hitting the Control Select or Command Select on Mac. And just like you can upload a file, you can also upload an entire folder as well. But now let's create a file from scratch. We'll create a Google Doc as an example, and you can click on the Google Docs option, or you can hover over the arrow to the right and you'll have the option to create a blank document or create a doc from a template. And by the way, you can use templates for any of these Google apps. So this is a perfect opportunity to talk about the power of templates. Though they've been basically around since the beginning of Google Drive, I really do think they remain one of the best Google Drive features. So check this out. Let's click on the Google Docs template option. A new tab opens and you can scroll through a boatload of doc templates like resumes, letters, different types of project proposals, sales templates, legal templates, contractor agreements. I mean, it goes on and on. So let's say you're working on a newsletter. You could just click on that template and voila, the template is automatically opened for you to edit. You can edit anything and everything, from the title to the text to the colors to the layout and more. So whether you create a blank file or one from a template, this new tab is automatically opened where you'll edit that particular file. And now that you've mastered creating files, you'll want to keep everything neat and organized in Google Drive. And there are quite a few ways to keep things neat and tidy. So first, from the new file you've created, at the top near your title, click on that little folder icon, select the folder you want to move it to, then click Move. Now, back in my Drive tab, I can open my folder and voila, there's the doc I created. But you can organize your files and folders right from your main Google Drive dashboard too. All you have to do is drag and drop your files into the folder. And remember, like we learned earlier, if you've got a ton of stuff going on in here, you can just right click, create a new folder, and then start dragging files directly into that folder, all right here without leaving this page. You can also right click directly on a file or folder to not only move it, but to access a whole whack of other features. One of these features is the ability to star a file. Of course, we can do this from your opened file as well. That will be at the top near your file name. But why click to open a file when you don't have to? Instead, we'll right click on the file and star it from there. And by the way, once you've starred something, it'll be found in your starred section in Google Drive on the left-hand side. But let's look at all these other options we have. You can share it or make a shareable link, which I will go over in detail in just a little bit. You can show file location, move it or favorite it, rename the file, copy the file, download it to your computer, or this is how to delete a file in Google Drive. There are so many features available with just a simple right click. Something else I like to do is color code folders. So with that right click on a folder, we can easily change its color. I like having this as a quick visual cue for my organization. And speaking of visual cues, something else you might have noticed is the different icons for different file types. So this is a quick visual cue from Google showing you without opening a file, whether it's a doc, a spreadsheet, a PDF, an audio file, or whatever it may be. So now let's talk about how to share files in Google Drive and set your desired sharing permissions. Remember how Google provides you with a visual cue as to what you're looking at? Well, if we go back to our list layout for a second, if you have this little icon with a person in it by one of your files, that means it's shared. Now, there are multiple ways to share a file. So you can do it from the file itself when you're creating it, or you can do it from your main Google Drive. So from the file itself, very quickly, you'll just click on the share button near the top right. But back in our Google Drive, like I showed you before, you can right click on any file in order to share it. Or if you click to select the file, in the top right of Drive, you'll have a few new options. If you click the person icon with a plus symbol, a sharing pop-up appears where you can add the email addresses of those you want to share with. You can add multiple people if you want. And to the right of the person you're adding, you can set the sharing permissions. You can allow them viewing access only, the ability to comment, or the ability to edit the document just as you can. Plus, you can write a little message to your collaborators too. So when you're all ready to share, just click on send. Now, if you want to remove someone, you can do that too. You're going to head back to your sharing permissions, and to the right of the email, you can transfer the ownership to them or remove their access entirely. And if you don't want to add people directly, you can also create a shareable link. So only people with the link can view the file. Right click on a file, or with the file selected, just click that link icon in the top right. And in this pop-up, you can copy the link as well as adjust the link sharing permissions here too. So if you're new to sharing and collaborating in Google Drive, you will definitely want to check out my other video because I show you all the cool collaboration features found within Google Drive. But really quickly, while we're going over some of these sharing options at the top, let's take a moment to highlight the detailed view. With your file selected, you'll have a little info icon. If you click on this, a right side panel will pop out, providing you with additional details about the file or folder you've selected. You're gonna see who has access, the file size, when it was created and modified, and by who. But as promised, another feature I wanna cover is your search feature in Google Drive. Once you have a lot of files in your drive, you're gonna wanna easily pull them up without scrolling through pages of files. So, in the search bar at the top, type in whatever it is you're looking for, and voila, it will appear for you. I use this all the time since my other account, I have like all my YouTube scripts, and sometimes I need to pull up an old one really quickly. But you can also access some advanced search features by clicking on the search bar and selecting advanced search from the dropdown, or by selecting the search options toggle in the right of the search bar. Here you can narrow down your search by what type of file or folder you're looking for. You can select the owner of the file. If you know the name or words found in the document or file, you can type that in as well as a lot of other advanced search features. It's so handy. And remember, if you want any more detail on really anything I've covered today, check out all the links in the description below. I'm telling you, a scientific calculation, there's a metric ton of Google Drive links in the description below. Enjoy. Well, that's my 2023 Google Drive tutorial. Hopefully you learned how to use Google Drive. And now I want to hear from you. What do you love about Google Drive and what are some of your favorite features? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel. And look at that, here and here for even more Google Drive content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.